Hello, pool players. Ron here. Welcome once again to the Pool Student Channel, and thank you very much for watching, everyone. What I want to show you here is an exercise that I have been working on, and some of you have seen that I have posted it in three different variations on the YouTube short format. This one here, I'm working on my stroke. I'm trying to have a more pronounced pause in my stroke. So this is a great drill. This is the Nick Varner drill. And notice there, I almost scratched. I tried to keep it close to that that three ball, and boy, I was close. But anyway, this is the Nick Varner nine ball drill. And I'm trying to work on this pause. And this pause is giving me a little bit of fits right now, but I know that it's going to take me some time before I can ingrain muscle memory to the point where I don't have to think as I shoot. As a result, it messes up my timing somewhat, and I'll miss a shot here and there. And you're gonna see one that I do miss that is, it really bothered me because it's the shot that I always practice. It's the 9-10 drill shot. And I thought, okay, I've got this run out with no problem, and I go ahead and miss it. So I'm gonna show you that I don't always run out, obviously. Notice here that I came up short. I have a very small window there to try to get in between that 9 and that 7, but I make an excellent kick, and I put spin on the ball to try to get it to come off the cushion and get down there for the 6, which it did. So, all good stuff here. Now, this is where things start to go awry, and once again, I'm trying to hold my pause a little bit, and it's bothering me a little here. I should have just shot this shot like I normally feel it, but I'm staying committed. I want to have a good pause. So let's see if the pause is in there like it should be. Yeah, the pause was decent, but the shot was not. Oh well. And I do talk to myself on occasion when something like that happens, so don't laugh too loud. Okay, so now I'm gonna go ahead and just finish it off. And actually, when I shoot this shot, I got a little bit straight here, and sometimes I get down on myself a little, and I really shouldn't, because I can make these shots, and right away I see that I can do it with some draw and some spin, and I will get really good on the 9 here. Nice draw, pull it back up table, not an issue, but I know my table speed, so I get it done. But anyway, because of that miss, what I then do is, I'm going to show you here, is I'm going to go ahead and do the 9-10 drill immediately. So of course I set up the same shot that I missed right away here, and of course I make the shot. Now, I gotta say something too. This is just to go to show you that when we think about something other than the task at hand, it can cause us to miss. Now let me explain that. When I shot that kick shot, I felt pretty good about that, and I put pressure on myself to think that I needed to really focus and run out this challenge. And those thoughts right there are why I missed the simple, you know, spin-induced throw shot that I'm shooting in this exercise that you see right now, this drill. So it's one that I normally never miss. Even here, I've got a real thin cut, but I get in shape, you know, no problem, make the shot. So it goes to show you, you gotta keep your head clear and just focus on the shot at hand, and you will run out. Now, I think that's pretty much it. I don't want to, you know, bore you guys too much more. I hope this is helpful. Stick with whatever you're trying to change, because if you don't, it's never going to happen for you. And in this case, I'm sticking with this pause. I'll get it done. I'll be able to shoot without thought, and I'll be a better player for it. Thanks for watching, everyone. And until next time, like I always say, keep on practicing.